Assalamu alaikum dear viewers, welcome back to our channel. How are you all? I hope you all are good. मैं हूं सिजाद,
मैं हूं उस्मान
और मैं हूं हसन
और मैं हूं सनी.
तो आज हसन कौन सा वीडियो देखना है?
आज हम देखेंगे जकार्ता ट्रैवल गाइड द कैपिटल ऑफ इंडोनेशिया.
ओके सो गाइस विदाउट फर्दर डिले लेट गेट स्टार्टेड टुडेज वीडियो. Jakarta
is the capital city of Indonesia and is a melting pot of a variety of different ethnicities from all over Indonesia. It's the hub where people from all over Indonesia come and you can find a vast variety of different...
which is Jakarta. It can be a little bit overwhelming as you first arrive in Jakarta due to the crowdedness and the vastness of the city, even for me too. So this video will cover some useful points for how to navigate your time here in Jakarta and what to do.
Nice way to travel along.
Is divided into five different districts, first being the north, central, west, east, and the south. When choosing where to stay, it is important to consider your budget, but also accessibility. The traffic in Jakarta can be madness, and it takes a long period of time, long hours, just to go for short distance.
Central Jakarta is the best place to stay for accessibility due to transportation links and the close vicinity to the main bigger landmarks, but can be relatively expensive. Another good option for tourists is South Jakarta, as there are a lot of choices for bars and street food. South Jakarta also has slightly more greenery and some nicer residential areas.
Okay.
I recommend using websites such as booking.com, Airbnb, or Hostel World. There are links in the description box if you would like to check them out. For hostels, you can find accommodation starting at around $6 per night, whereas hotels or Airbnbs start from $20 to $30
per
night for a decent place in a good location.
Affordable price.
A common mistake people make is not realizing how long it takes to get places in Jakarta, and they opt for cheaper accommodation in Greater Jakarta area, thinking they can easily travel in. But it can take 2 to 3 hours to even travel short distances. Yes. So I would recommend to spend a little more on staying nearer the center, as you will probably save money and save lots of time in the long run from traveling in and out. When you first arrive in Jakarta, you need to get to the city from the airport. It can take 1 hour to 2 hours to get into Jakarta. There are several different options for getting to the city. The first option would be to take taxi or use online taxi apps such as Grab and Gojek. I would recommend installing these apps before you travel. You can also download offline Google Maps or Maps.me of the Jakarta area. If you want to call down a taxi without using an app, look for the blue taxis from the company called Bluebird. There are a respectable taxi company who will use meter prices. Another option is taking the airport train. If you want to get the train, it will take you to the Sudirman Station, which is the closest stop to central Jakarta. To withdraw money, I would wait until you reach the city. Most ATMs have a withdrawal limit of 1.5 million to 2.5 million rupiah. A lot of places accept card in central Jakarta, but you will definitely need cash if you want to experience street food.
one of the very popular locals' breakfast is called chicken porridge or bubur ayam. It is available widely throughout Jakarta on the streets. Just look out for the sign of bubur ayam.
Jakarta transport system,
easy,
especially MRT, is awesome.
It's delicious and it's cheap. This is Chinese influenced type of food we have in Indonesia. So they put a lot of chicken broth, serve like curry sauce. That's why it's yellow. They put lots of peanuts, spring onions, everything there is. I just love this in the morning. About getting ripped off by taxi drivers, don't worry so much because there are two different alternatives of online taxi application. First being Gojek, second being Grab. These are a very convenient and very easy way to take you around from places to places in Jakarta. Right now, I am going to order a taxi to visit some sites in Jakarta. I do only have to wait in between 3 to 5 minutes maximum, depending on the driver's location. But most of
why
the time, the application itself will snatch those drivers that is already close to you.
I think she should use MRT in Jakarta because MRT services are best in Jakarta.
To MRT of Jakarta. This is one of
MRT. I was talking about this MRT.
Has just been recently opened in Jakarta. If you are based in central Jakarta and if you're thinking of transporting to south of Jakarta and want to avoid the traffic, this could be the best way to do it. So
yes.
Here's a system map that you can use as a sort of system of reference. You can see there are plenty of stops from central Jakarta all the way through south Jakarta. So we are now going to buy a ticket and I'll show you a little bit how
prepaid
to
car must buy.
There are two ways of buying the ticket, first being by the machine, the second being through ticket office. If you are not familiar with the language, actually I would recommend you to buy through the machine because it provides English language as one of the options. We've got our ticket. Let's go.
Prepaid card.
Travel kariye.
For MRT.
As well as paying for the stops that you are going to, you're also paying for a refundable ticket of 15,000 rupiah. It is refundable if you finish and reach your destination, then refund this to the ticket office.
train.
The free
hop on an off-city tour bus is a good way to get a glimpse of the various sites in Jakarta. If you want to use this bus, it operates every day until...
If you wish to travel by Lokulus, I will leave some useful links in the description below.
Since it can be more complicated, I would suggest making use of taxi apps, city tour bus, MRT and train.
Like any other metropolitan city throughout the world, Jakarta also has plenty of sightseeing and landmarks such as national monument, museums, church, mosque, and also Old Town, where I am currently at. So this area is quite unique in comparison to the rest of Jakarta because you can still see colonial buildings remaining. After being out and about in such hot and humid Jakarta, we are getting pretty hungry, so we are excited to head out to find some more street food. Part of Indonesian experience, and there are lots to try in Jakarta. Many people may have known about nasi goreng or fried rice, but there's so much goreng. More than just that. There's so much more to Indonesian cuisine. If there is one thing that I would like to recommend you to try is satay. We have different types of satay from ayam, which means chicken, kambing, which means lamb, and also lidah, which means tongue. The most common one that is easily found in Jakarta is called sate ayam or chicken sears.
सही कह लेता लकड़ी की सीखे
हाँ लकड़ी की वो वैसे पकड़ा दो और वो खाते जाए और जलते जाए ना इंटरेस्टिंग है Either iron
if you want something that is a bit more soupy, we have different types of soup from chicken soup, lamb soup, oxtail soup, and the one that I'm going to have is called sop iga or rib soup. I don't know how does it taste like, but let's just wait.
मीट
ये है क्या इसका नाम नहीं बताया इसने
बीफ बहुत वाटरिंग
Martabak is a stuffed pig, which is a famous in Indonesia, in Malaysia, Singapore, and Indonesia.
two types of martabak
that can be found easily throughout Jakarta, such as savory and sweet. While it is baked on a pan, the sweet martabak is spread with butter, sugar, crushed peanuts, chocolate sprinkles, cheese, and other toppings.
Cheese of the year, and this is very famous in Jakarta, Indonesia. Special dish.
Mie ayam or chicken noodles is a common Indonesian dish of seasoned yellow noodles topped with diced chicken meat. It is especially common in Indonesia, Singapore, and Malaysia, and can trace its origin to Chinese cuisine. In Indonesia, chicken noodles are often seasoned with soy sauce and chicken oil that is made from chicken fat and mixture of spices.
There is such great variety of street food in Jakarta, but I can't cover it all in one single video. I still hope that this will give you a glimpse of what you can eat while you're here. This is the end of today's episode. I hope that you enjoy a slightly different type of this video.
So guys, ye tha aaj ka video. Video bahut hi shandar tha aur mujhe to bahut pasand aaya hai. Unka ye vlog bahut kamal ka tha. Usman se poochte hain, Usman ko kaisa?
Video waqai hi bahut achhi thi. Mujhe sabse zyada jo pasand aaya wo MRT system tha. Wo maine first time dekha hai. Mujhe waqai bahut pasand aaya.
Hasan,
video bahut kamal ki thi aur latest and nice vlog. Jakarta is a beautiful shahar.
Yes, Hasan, Sunny.
Jakarta to waqai bahut khoobsurat hai. Iski jitni tareef kare utni kam hai. Aur sabse zyada mujhe to food street unki khane peene ki cheeze achhi lagti hai. Kamal ki cheeze hoti hai unki.
Yes. Oh. Food is fantastic. Food was looking like delicious and especially martaba is very famous in Indonesia. So we hope guys you enjoyed this video with us, and inshallah we will back tomorrow with a new latest video. So for now, goodbye, take care, have a nice day.